Hi, this is Artin Behdad, and in this video, I'm going to talk about 12 of my mistakes that caused me a lot of money. You know, in mistake number one, I lost a lot of money. And in mistake number two, I missed a lot of profitable trends that I could make a lot of money from them, but I missed them. I will teach you this in this video because it's very important to you too. In fact, I made these mistakes because I learned trading by reading and watching workshop of stock markets, or futures markets, options, and all the material that works on that market. But they're a little different in Forex. You know, when I use those material in Forex, it worked pretty good, and I like it very much. But in some cases, there was some differences. The mistake number one was in those books, when, for example, they want to say, put your stop here, they said, put your stop one tick below the bar. One tick because the high and low of the bar makes a weak support and resistance, and it's pretty natural. Market comes there and goes again. For example, comes down and goes up again. One tick. This number, one tick. When I wanted to use this one tick in Forex market, I used one pip below of the bar. Okay? And in many cases, I've seen price comes back and take my stop out of the market and goes in my way. It means my strategy is okay, my analyzing is okay, entry point is okay, but there is something wrong with this one pip. Fortunately, one of my friends told me this five pips, not one pip, and this five pips is because there is a difference between timing in interbank and brokers that you should put five pips instead of one pip. And I used it and experienced it, and it's proven, you know, I used it a lot. And it's proven, and you should use 5 pips below of the bar you want to set your stop loss. Okay? 5 pips instead of 1 pip. This 5 pips is very important. And in buy a stop, when you should want to trade buy, and for example, put your stop loss here in the below of the bar, put your stop loss 5 pip below of the bar. Okay? 5. In sell a stop, you want to put sell a stop, because I always trade buy a stop and sell a stop, you know. I don't trade other form of orders, but it doesn't make any difference. In sell, you should put your stop loss 5 pip plus spread pips above the bar you want to put your stop loss. Okay? In buy, 5 pips below the bar. In sell, 5 pips plus a spread pip. If you don't know, please pay attention. If you don't know why you should add these spread pips, for example, in Euro USD is 2 pips, why you should add 2 pips plus these 5 pips, please email me because it's very important. I didn't explain it here because it wasn't my mistake. And please email me. It's very easy. I will teach you in a couple of sentences. It's not something difficult. So this is it. In buy, 5 pips below. In sell, 5 pips plus spread pips above. Second mistake. When I was learning, analyzing those markets, I used timing analyzing. It's like price analyzing, but it's in horizontal line, timing analyzing. It's a little similar, but different. And it worked pretty well in other markets. But when I used it in Forex, I missed a lot of profitable trends. You know, I missed a lot of profitable trend that was matched in my price analyzing, but they didn't match with my time analyzing. And I find out timing is not very good in Forex. You know, as a Forex trader, you should focus on price analyzing. And you've seen, when I taught you in the 3 days free analyzing course, If you haven't watched it, I recommend you to watch it because the link is below of in this video. And at this course, I never talked about timing because it's unnecessary. You don't need to use time analyzing for Forex trade. Okay? If it was necessary, I would tell you for sure. Okay? So I lived analyzing, time analyzing. And for analyzing, I just use price analyzing in Forex. So the correct is you don't need time analyzing in Forex. That's it. It was two mistakes because of first mistake. I lost money because of second mistake. Because of the filtering, I missed a lot of profitable trends. If you have any similar experience, please share it with me. Email it to me. Thank you.